And he's the son of David and the son of Abraham. Notice the teaching method here. You summarize before you do the detail. You summarize, you give your basic purpose statement, then you unpack it. So he doesn't begin by giving a whole list, he gets to that later, but you've got to see that Jesus was the son of David, who was the main king, as you know. And David is mentioned more in the Bible than Jesus is, actually, numerically. Of course, Jesus is more important than David, we know that, but David is key. He's the son of David, and he's also the son, meaning the descendant, right? Not literally the son, you've got to read descendant there. Jesus was the descendant of David and the descendant of Abraham. Abraham is what, 2000 BC? And David is about 1000 BC. That gives you the broad idea, right? Now with the broad idea, we get to the detail, which is more difficult. Abraham was the father of Isaac, then we get more specific. Isaac, the father of Jacob and Judah and the brothers and so on. Jacob, the father of Judah and his brothers. So Judah's picked out here. Judah was the father of Perez and so on by Tamar. You've got some of the detail. Down in verse 11, Josiah, who was also a good king, became the father of, now this guy is a little bit difficult, Jeconiah, otherwise known as Jehoiakim. If you remember the N, he followed somebody called Jehoiakim with an M. You remember that way? Jehoiakim. But what is said about Jehoiakim in the Bible is that nobody could be a royal descendant of his. Okay, there's another version of his name there. Coniah is Jehoiakim, who followed Jehoiakim, M preceding N. Now he's said to be childless. Let's read on. 28. Is this man Coniah, otherwise known as Jehoiakim, a despised, shattered jar, you bet? Or is he an undesirable vessel? Why have he and his descendants been hurled out, cast into a land that they do not know? How can Jesus then be related to him? The throne ceased with this awful man, Jehoiakim. Now this is, I'll grant, a little bit more complicated than some things in the Bible. If you want to read up on this, you're going to get the book by Lord Harvey, H-E-R-V-E-Y. That was a British title. Lord Harvey was a clergyman, and he wrote a very fat piece on the genealogies of Jesus. And I'm not going to say that I know for sure how this works, but I can tell you certain things. The genealogies of Jesus Christ. I don't think it's online yet, but anyway, you've got the idea. Jehoiakim's line ceased. He's childless. So what are you going to do? He's got no son. What happened to the royal line then? Verse 12, back in Matthew 1. Let's do verse 11 to pick up the story. Josiah became the father of Jeconiah, otherwise known as Coniah, otherwise known as Jehoiakim. You got it? Luke 3:27. You've got Shealtiel, the son of Neri. Okay, so what appears to have, let me make this very simple. What appears to have happened is this. Well, since this man was childless, they borrowed somebody from another David line, right? So there are two David lines, are there not? Solomon line. And who's the other one? Nathan, another son, right? So if you are stopping the line through from Solomon, what's going to happen? You can still have a Davidite by going from the other son of David, who was Nathan. And that's what Luke has done here. So the suggestion would be that the Shealtiel didn't have a child. So they took another one from the different line, from the Nathan line, where Shealtiel was said to be the son of Neri, N-E-R-I. According to Luke, Shealtiel was the son of Neri. Here's how you remember it. Nathan line N, Neri, and Shealtiel was the son. So they said, let's take this, I think it's the same person, let's take Shealtiel and put him into the line here. So the simple idea is this. Jehoiakim, he's the bad guy, right? Jehoiakim, he's okay, the father. Jehoiakim, M-N. Jehoiakim had no children. So who succeeded him on the throne? The answer is, I'll throw this in, Zedekiah was the last king of Judah. Was his uncle. Was actually his uncle. Zedekiah was the uncle of Jehoiakim. He was the only royal one available, so they made him king, and he was the last king of Judah. Nebuchadnezzar put an end to him. That was the end of the whole thing. So Zedekiah was the uncle of Jehoiakim, who had no children. So what are you going to do with the royal line going to the Messiah? You go to the Nathan line, and you apparently find this Shealtiel in there, where he's the son of Neri. That's a legal trick, right? 23 of Luke 3 says Jesus was about 30, and he, as was supposed, I like that, right? As was supposed, he was the son of Joseph. Legally speaking, he was, who was the son of Eli. All the way back to 27, where you have, there's Shealtiel. The theory is that's the same guy as was mentioned in the Matthew. It's a very, in the Matthew list, it's a very rare name. So it seems that they took the Shealtiel from this line, who was the son of Neri. And all the way down then, 31, the son of Meleah, son of Menna, the son of Mattata, the son of Nathan, the son of David. There it is. Not the Solomon line, but the Nathan line. You remember, Enonen, Neri, and Nathan. All the way back to Abraham, isn't that wonderful? Back to Noah, I love that. Methuselah even, who was rather old. Down to 38, the son of Enosh, son of Seth, and the son of Adam. And he was the son of God. Isn't that beautiful? All the way back to God now. Adam was the son of God. Jesus the son of God. Supernaturally. It's a new Genesis, isn't it? That actually implies of itself a virginal birth, doesn't it? Actually, we should call it virginal conception.